Kannan Gopinathan quit his IAS job last year because of what happened in Kashmir, and he spoke to Maya Sharma in Bengaluru on his response to what the Supreme Court observed yesterday, that the freedom of expression also covered the right of access to the internet, and how self-censorship is the biggest threat we all face when it comes to freedom of expression.
See, it was very clear that what we are doing in Kashmir after the post-abrogation of 370, for me at least, that is a very clear violation of fundamental rights. The internet part and the unreal sort of 144 orders which has been put in there for continuously and repeatedly, and now the Supreme Court has said that it needs to be reviewed, and the freedom of expression also contains the freedom to express through internet. Which sort of validates the stand, but it, unfortunately, I don't think it gives any remedy to the people there.
Okay.
So for us, maybe theoretically we can say yes, some constitutional question has been answered. But I think it is also a day-to-day livelihood question for people who are there, and they were really looking forward to get an answer today. To them, the judgment would be disappointing. And if the Supreme Court wanted to say that it had to be reviewed by under the rules, it could have said so maybe 2 months back, and then asked the petitioners to come to the Supreme Court after that review is done. Now they ask the review to do it in 7 days, and then again come back and. It's actually people's day-to-day lives, and there should have been a bit more urgency. I'm sorry, but there should have been a bit more urgency in dealing with such matters. I am a lot more hopeful now than when I had resigned, because I had resigned not because what the government did. I had resigned because of lack of reaction from the common citizens.
Okay.
And
you're seeing that reaction now.
Yeah, entire city was pretty much shut down, when entire state was pretty much shut down, the leaders were jailed, elected leaders were jailed, and youth have been sent to different states, all for the pretext of national security or national interest. Part of it is right, okay, but then it's our duty as citizens to stand up for Kashmiris. The national integration would have happened if all of us would have stood up and say we won't let this happen to our
see that happen.
No, in fact, the media, a lot of us were showing that the Kashmiris are celebrating, and lot of the media actually even decided not to show, because they didn't want to show the pro side, so they decided to keep quiet and not show the, and what is the reality. And a lot of us, the judiciary, be it say the civil society, did try to do, but not to the extent of, at least the political opposition have been highly ambivalent. They didn't want to take a position, because whether taking a position on Kashmir would, everything became vote, and they were not asking for what is right, what is wrong. And I was really upset with that. So individually, all I could do was to resign and at least say that what I felt is, something is happening is wrong. After that, I have been traveling across. It's been like 40 plus cities now, and more than 14 states that I have traveled and met people and talked about. But when the NRC and Citizenship Amendment Act question came, the fundamental aspect of our secularism or the secular constitution, the idea itself got challenged. People realized that democracy is not just about running a Twitter campaign or hashtag and trending or Instagram or memes or TikTok videos. Okay. The youth, which otherwise would have just thinking that WhatsApp is where the information is, or or Twitter is where the democracy is, they actually reclaim this democracy, they reclaim this country.